Glory be to God. I want to show you the way forward. The way forward. Now, children of God, I am here to offer you the way to eliminate evil. The way for us to eliminate evil. In Africa, in America, in Asia, in Europe. The way to eliminate evil. And the children of God are forsaking this easy and simple way that God, our God, has given to us. And they are doing the thing that is not profitable. So I am here to offer you a way for all these things we are seeing. All the evil in the name of church, all the evil in the name of authority, because the highest authority is the church. So if you get the evil in the church arrested and destroyed, the authority of this world, they don't have power, they don't have choice, they don't have power. They depend on church. That's why they can't do anything without inviting anything called pastor or bishop or whatever to come. Because they know that they are the first authority. For unto us a child is born, unto us, you know, a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. The authority of this world is under the authority of the church. So when the church failed, the whole system, the whole world have failed. The whole world have failed. So now, I want to offer you now as God, I want to give you something to do. If you want to see a great change, now, do this. Do this. I'm reading now 2 Corinthians chapter 10 from verse 3. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 from verse 3. For though we walk, live in the flesh, we are not carrying on our warfare according to the flesh, and using mere human weapons. For the weapons of our warfare are not physical weapons of flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God. They are mighty before God for the overthrow and destruction of strongholds. But they are mighty before God for the overthrow and destruction of strongholds. There is no power that's above prayer. When you are a child of God, when you are truly born again, Holy Ghost filled and sanctified as a believer, as a child of God, that are giving your life in totality to Him, reading His Word, the highest weapon that you supposed to have or to carry every time is prayer. Is prayer. Because the spirit in you is the spirit that gave birth to everything that they use to fashion any bomb, any knife, any gun, any missile. The Spirit of God gave birth to everything. So when you have the Spirit of God inside of you, which means you have their master. You have their master in you, and what you are saying is what they will do. What you are speaking from your mouth, you can say, point anything to die, that thing is bound to die. Anything you say, live, that thing will live. So God gave us so much power that's above every weapon, all the weapons of warfare, by giving us His Spirit that gave birth to all these things. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made. All things were made, including all the metal, all the weapon, all the raw material they used to produce any weapon. All things were made through Him. Without Him, nothing was made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men, and the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness can never comprehend it. So if you understand that the Spirit of God gave it to everything that they used to produce, weapon, then you begin to pray according to the will of God. An example like now, not sitting down on internet talking and gossiping and about fake pastors. You can use that time to pray. Pray against them. They are operating with spirit. They are operating with power. They are operating with evil power. But you have a spiritual power that when you are talking, they will go and hide. When you appeared, you are like you are a lion. They will hear about. They will go and hide. When you speak, let their powers be destroyed. It must be destroyed because you have the power. You have the master instead of you, the spirit that gave birth to those things, that gave birth to those weapons. I show you in the book of Isaiah so that you understand me very, very well. I want to show you so that you can get me. I want you to understand the power that Christians have forsaken. Christians have kept their weapon and the enemy is busy taking territory. Where you have the highest missile, the highest bomb, the atomic bomb. You have the highest weapon, but you just carry it that is loaded and dump it and you are going empty, talking and gossiping about what the evil is doing. Instead of you to carry out that weapon and get every evil where they belong. I want to show you now in the book of Isaiah, so that you can understand me very well, the power that's in prayer. You better stop sitting down and talking and about what the evil people are doing, what the fake people are, pastors are doing in the name of the Lord. Begin to pray. It's time to pray. Prayer is the highest power that can destroy all the evil churches, destroy all the evil pastors, destroy all the evil authority, destroy all the native doctors, destroy all the cabals that is saying that your country, your nation will not move forward. That said that this world, that Jesus will not take over his inheritance. It's time for you to lift up that weapon. Lift up, rise up in the inner man. If you are born again, child of God, that have God's spirit, release that atomic bomb and let every devil and demon die. I want to read this thing for you. You know, look at what God said here. Behold, they may gather together and stay up strive, but it is not for me. Whoever stays up strive against you shall fall and surrender to you, because you have the master spirit. Behold, I have created this smith. God is the one that created this smith, who blows on the fire of coals, and who produces a weapon for its purpose. And I have created the devastator. You as a child of God, God has created you as devastator to destroy. See? But no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against you in judgment you shall show to be in the wrong. This peace, righteousness, security, triumph over opposition is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, those in whom the ideal servant of the Lord is reproduced. This is the righteousness or the vindication which they obtain from me. This is that which I impart to them as their justification, says the Lord. You just hear what I read now? Stop talking about fake pastors, what they are doing. Stop bringing their video, showing the people. Stop that. Stop sitting down and analyzing with your group. Stop bringing their videos. Stop bringing their private jets. Stop bringing their families. Stop bringing their anything they do. Take your eyes off of them. Take your eyes. If you continue doing it, God says, I should warn you. God says it's a sign, it's a mark that you are one of them. That if you keep on bringing them, showing them to the people, see their wife, see the car they bought, see their mansion, see their jet, see what they are doing. God said that if you continue doing that you are not his own child. You are simply glorifying evil. Anything you give your mouth, anything you talk so much, you give growth to that. Give God growth with you. Truly love Jesus, love his kingdom, love to see evil to be no more. You just hear what I read now. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Pray morning after night, you will see a great change. You will see that evil will be no more. I am not the one that said it. The one of God said it. You will see evil no more. the evil we see today, you will see them. You will see them no more. Stop gossiping. Tell somebody, stop gossiping. Stop this internet gossiping. Stop this evil broadcasting evil. Stop advertising evil. Tell somebody, give your mouth to something that is profitable. Give your mouth to something. Carry your AK-47. Your AK-47 is PRAYER. Lift it up. Shoot it. Every devil and demon will die. Prayer. There's power in prayer. Pray against fake pastors, fake churches, all the evil they are doing. Decree all of them to end, all of them to wither. And I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus, let evil we are seeing today, as we all stand and give our mouths to prayer, and give our strength to prayer, and give our energy to prayer, and give every, our being to prayer, let evil be no more. Let wickedness be no more. Let anything, fake pastors, fake churches be no more. Let them be shattered. Let them be destroyed. Let them be demolished through the power, through the fire that will flow from the Spirit of God, through the liquid prayer of the saints. Let them melt as wax melt before the fire. Let the wicked perish at the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus.